let any man, any flesh speak. You are going to speak the word here, sins. Father, I need myself for you to use me, to bring glory to your name. Father, let it be that we will live here with your words written on the tablets of our heart, where we will live to glorify your name. Father, we thank you for the entire congregation, even those who are not here, and all majority of us are not here. Father, let it be that we flow together in the spirit, no matter where they are. That when we meet next time, we move according to the direction of the spirit. We thank you for your church. Father, we bless you for the gifts. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your anointing. We thank you for your continual visitation of us. Father, we are grateful. I must say thank you. I surrender for you to use me in this moment to your glory. In Jesus' name, let the saints of God say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm going to talk about obedience. I remember the last part two or the last part three, I ministered on the subject trust and obey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
However, before they even told me to minister today, last week I ministered, so it wasn't, I know I'm free. And, you know, I go to the gym at times. Not at times, I try and as much as I can. You know, hallelujah.
Amen.
I will fight the bondage. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when I was at the gym, you know, most, some of us who have been at the gym, you see they have TVs. And they put a whole lot of TVs on different stations. So I was on the treadmill walking. And then, all of a sudden, I saw one of the stations they put for the animals, where the animals, as dogs mostly, go on competition. You know, they bring dogs for this thing and this one will win. And this particular time, it was a woman dog who won. And I can see the joy in this woman's eyes. And tears, you know, tears of joy was involved.
Amen.
So they were showing how the whole thing took place. Different dogs. And this, when I was there, it's like, it's a message that God was sending to me. Every day God speaks to his children.
Hallelujah.
Every blessed day, amen, God speaks. Yeah. Unless you don't want to hear.
Amen.
Let me just pause on to this side. You see, sometimes, I remember sometimes I would be in the house sleeping. Then I wake up. You know what wake me up? You know when we are at work, most of us work in the hospital and the nursing home. You know, when the patient put the light on, the call light, it will be calling. Sometimes I wake up, it's like, there's a call. Like I'm at work. I don't know, I wake up and say, I'm not going to work. Why the time? I'm not going to work off today. The reason I'm saying that, there may be noise here. But some of you will not hear the noise. Mm. It will depend on the noise we hear. There will be different noise. Mm. I already even said something more than one time. He says something that will be noise, but he doesn't hear. God is tuned to different dimension. He's tuned to different spirit. So that's the voice that he hears. Sometimes, in the hospital especially, there are certain patients who are on the alarm because they are confused, they may jump. And then, when we unlock the bed, there's another voice. So at times, you have that patient who has the bed alarm who doesn't sound louder. And the one they put alarm for confused patient, that was sound loud. But if you don't have the one that is louder, and the two are up at the same time, you know the one you will hear.
Amen.
Because that's the one that you know that you are concerned of.
Hallelujah.
In the same way it is, there are so many voices.
Hallelujah.
What voice are you tuned to?
Hallelujah.
That's why, if you will have Israel, and Muhammad started well. He saw the Jewish people as serving God and he wanted his people to serve God. So a time came that when he had an opportunity, he went and he was meditating in the cave, teaching about how I will get my people to serve God. And
when the voice spoke.
Mm.
And now I say, I'm Allah. A lot of people sometimes say the same God is not. Is the God of creation who spoke to you? Or the voice of your own heart desire? Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now let's come back to my point. So now while I was watching, I know where I always tune. I always pray, I always want God to speak. Every person that God speaks to me in different dimensions.
Yeah.
When I speak about that, you must say, it even came and talk about the drifting. That one happened at the hospital where we have this nice, wonderful grandma who was so weak in bed. As soon as he slid a little, he wanted to pull her. He slid a little, he wanted to come and pull her. The mother said, why do you keep sliding? He said, you know. Then it hit me. That's the way we slide without knowing as Christians. Unless we put ourselves to the test and take stock in our lives.
Amen.
And be careful whether we are standing. The message came. So everything God is speaking. So when I was watching these dogs and the owner, I saw something. There are so many things that is said about obedience. I wanted to talk about the benefits of obedience.